Okay. Now the comparison between BJT and MOSFET. Okay, for MOSFET we have calculated the GM value is 2IDS by VOV. So if I take GM by IDS ratio, I get it is 2 divided by VOV. Now, if you increase the value of VOV, what will happen? VOV is VG minus VT, right? Now, if I increase the value of VOV, that means VG minus VT, this will force the device to linear region. Why? Because for linear saturation region, if you see, for saturation region, your VG minus VT, this value, that means VOV should be less than VDS. If you start increasing your VOV, it will drag your device to this condition. That means your VG minus VT, that means VOV will at some point become greater than VDS. So you will end up in linear region. So you can't operate your, you will not get any gain. In fact, so your amplifier will not work. And what if you make VOV very small? What will happen if you make your VOV very small? It will lead to a low IDS value. Why? Look at the IDS current like this. This is the IDS current, right? In saturation? No, it's not in saturation. This is the saturation current, IDS current, right? Now, if you make your VOV, this is VOV. If you make your VOV very small, your IDS will go down. And if IDS is going down, your GM value will go down, because your GM in saturation region, your GM is a function of IDS. IDS is low, GM is low, GM is low, gain is low. So you can't even go a very high VOV, you can't even go a very small VOV. Both ways you have limitations. So what you have to do, you have to find out a typical GM value which satisfy both the end. Okay, so the typically the VOV value are in between 200 to 500 millivolts more or less. So if let us take 200 millivolts your VOV value, in that case you'll find GM by IDS value is 2 by 200 millivolt. So as it is millivolt, we have added 1000 over here, because it is basically 200 into 10 to the power minus 3 volt. Just I have added this 10 to the power minus 3. So it is 10 to the power minus 3 will reflect on top as into 1000. So simple calculation. So it will be 2 into 1000 by 200, which is more or less 10. So for a VOV, typical value 200 millivolt, your GM by IDS is 10. Now what if I start increasing my VOV value? Then this will be even less than 10. This term will become even less than 10. Why? Because VOV is at the denominator side. So if I increase VOV, your GM by IDS, this ratio will go down. Whatever I have right now at 200 will go down. And I can't even reduce the VOV value further, because it will reduce my IDS value, which is very important for my device operation. So you have a typical GM by VDS value is more or less close to 10. However, in BJT, what was GM? In BJT, the GM is QIC by KT. So if I take GM by IC ratio, it is Q by KT, and this is more or less 38. We have already seen, we have calculated this, right? For T equal to 300 Kelvin. So if you see the values, this GM by IDS and GM by IC, clearly GM by IC is greater than GM by IDS. In fact, for higher VOV, you have GM by IDS less than 10. So it's at least 3 times, 4 times higher. So definitely BJT provides a higher GM value. That I have said, that for a given biasing voltage or given biasing condition, the GM value in BJT will be higher, because IC value will be higher, compared to ideas. So here also, I'm trying to make the same point that BJT will provide an higher GM, and when you have a higher GM, you have higher gain, you have higher bandwidth as well. The omega T value, I said previously, the omega T value, which is also proportional to GM. So if higher GM means you have higher omega T value, so you will get an higher bandwidth as well. But BJT will take or drain more current. BJT will take, it will consume a lot of power, which is an issue. And another disadvantage is BJT's input impedance is much lower compared to CMOS, because in CMOS there is very less current, or in fact zero current ideally in case of CMOS. I mean CMOS mean MOSFET. In case of MOSFET, there is very less current in the input. So you have a very high input impedance, which is desirable. So the best part of MOSFET is the power requirement is less. Okay, as of now what I have said, as of now what I have shown. However, GM value in BJT is higher. So if somebody gives me an option, I probably will choose BJT for this analog circuit design if I need a more gain, more bandwidth, if people provide me enough power. Otherwise, it will be a trouble. Okay. Now let us see what is the limitation of this MOSFET small signal model. We already have seen BJT small signal model. Now let us see what happens in MOSFET small signal model. There must be a limitation. What is the limitation in BJT small signal model? Your signal must be less than VT, much less than VT actually. So VT means thermal voltage, not threshold, remember. So let me say, in BJT the signal, input signal should be much less than thermal voltage, that is 26 millivolt more or less. So you can't go beyond say 5 millivolt, 10 millivolt. Even if you come closer to VT, closer to 26 millivolt. Every time I keep on saying VT, I should not say while I'm teaching the MOSFET, because it will increase the confusion. So let us say 26 millivolt or thermal voltage. Even if we come, even if you bring the input voltage in BJT close to that 26 millivolt, you'll see that small signal model is no longer valid for BJT. So here also, we should find what is the limitation, how far we can go. Okay, so we already have seen there are some advantages of BJT, which I said previously, I mean in initial lectures, that BJT people prefer because of it will get high gain, high bandwidth. But there are issues as well, like input resistance or like current, just now I've shown the power. Okay, let's see what is the small signal model of MOSFET. So just like previous case of BJT, this is the circuit. Okay, so you have a DC bias VGS and you have a AC signal small v small gs. So these notations I already have discussed in BJT, so I am not repeating this. So you have a total VGS, which is AC plus DC. Okay, so this part is AC, this is DC. Now the total current will be beta n by 2 VGS minus VT, but here currently we have another term called VGS, so I added plus VGS whole square into 1 plus lambda VDS. Anyways, we are going to neglect this term because everywhere we are considering lambda to be very small. Remember, lambda we are neglecting in case of current calculation. However, in case of output resistance calculation, here we cannot neglect lambda, because if lambda is zero, this is parallel to the x-axis. That means your output resistance is infinite. Even in this equation, you can see if it is zero, it is infinite. So here we cannot neglect lambda. This will lead to an infinite input resistance, which is physically not possible. You have some value, right? However, in case of current calculation, just to get rid of the complexity, we are considering lambda to be very small. Is it correct? Just keep that in mind, okay? So your IDS value is currently beta n by 2 VGS minus VT plus VGS whole square. What was the IDS value previously we said? It is like IDS beta n by 2 VGS minus VT whole square. This was the value, neglecting this term 1 plus lambda VGS. You can also include. This was the value. Just to remind you the equation so that you don't get confused. Now in this case, you have this term intact here, but we have a VGS extra term. So I just added this term. Okay. Now your AC IDS will be total IDS minus DC IDS. So total IDS I already have shown here. Just neglect this and put the value over here, total IDS, which is beta n by 2 VGS minus VT plus VGS whole square minus the DC IDS. Here is the DC IDS. Beta n by 2 VGS minus VT whole square. Do simple algebra. Beta n by 2 you can take common, and then it is a plus b whole square. A square plus b square plus 2ab. And here you have VGS minus VT whole square. These two will be cancelled. So you are end up with beta n by 2. Take VGS and 2. I mean, VGS is common in both the terms. So you take 2 VGS in common and take it outside this bracket. So you'll find VGS by 2, because it was VGS square. So 1 VGS I've taken out. And as there was no 2, so 1, 2 will come in the denominator. And here 2 VGS, if I take out, it is VGS minus VT. Is that okay? These 2 and 2 will get cancelled. You have beta n VGS. And then I have taken VGS minus VT out of this bracket. So you have 1 for this. And then VGS divided by 2 into VGS minus VT. Is that clear? It's a simple algebra, you can do it. I have explained here. If you have any confusion, you do it by yourself, you'll get to know. Okay, this expression. So you are end up with this expression of IDS. So this is the current expression of our IDS that we have seen here. Beta n VGS into VGS minus VT plus 1 plus VGS divided by 2 VGS minus VT. That is what I have written here. Beta n VGS, VGS minus VT, 1 plus VGS divided by 2 VGS minus VT. Okay. Now, what is the value of beta n into VGS minus VT? We already have calculated. If you look at the calculation here, the GM value, whatever we have calculated, if you look at here, you'll find GM is equal to beta n VGS minus VT. So I can replace this beta n VGS minus VT as GM. That is what I exactly have done over here. So these two I have replaced with GM. We have VGS, and this is as it is. 1 plus VGS divided by 2 VGS minus VT. Okay. Now in small signal analysis, what is the purpose? My purpose is your output source should look something like GM into input voltage, whatever is this. Even in BJT, we have done it. What was that? GM into VBE. VBE was your input voltage. And here also, we have a similar term, IDS equal to GM into input voltage VGS into this term. So, in case of small signal analysis, to make it valid, what we need to do? We need to make a condition where we can neglect this term VGS divided by 2 VGS minus VT. And what is the condition? If VGS is very, very less than this 2 into VGS minus VT, we can neglect this term. And this is our small signal condition. Or this is where we should limit our VGS value, where VGS is very, very less than 2 into VGS minus VT. If you consider this, you will find the small signal current term IDS equal to GM into VGS. This is our purpose for small signal analysis. So your IDS now, this side it will be IDS, right? Is GM into VGS. This is the equivalent circuit. So this is gate, this is drain, your source is grounded. See here, your source is grounded. This is source, this is drain, right? This is source, this is, just a minute, make it even more clear. So this is source, this is drain, and this is your gate, right? So your source is grounded. Here also in the circuit, your source is grounded. You have gate, drain. In the gate side, you have signal VGS, which I have shown. This is VGS. And in the output side, you have the current source, which is equivalent to GM VDS. That is what we have currently proven. For the condition, there is a condition. The condition is your VGS should be very, very less than 2 into VGS minus VT. Now, this is, if you see, this is, this part we call it VOV, V over voltage. Now, what is the typical value of V over voltage? We have taken previously V over voltage to be 200 millivolt. Let's take this value only. That's why your VGS should be very, very less than 2 into 200 millivolt. That means, which is equal to 400 millivolt. So your small signal voltage should be, say around 40 millivolt, say around 30 millivolt. At least one order less we are taking. It is 400. So we can take one order less, that is divided by 10. So 40 millivolt, we can say 40 millivolt is very, very less than 400 millivolt, right? Now, if you use VOV, which you can use up to 500, in that case, you can go a little higher as well. But what was the input voltage for BJT? Very small. It should be, in case of BJT, your input voltage should be less than 26 millivolt. So you can operate maybe in 3 millivolt, 5 millivolt, maximum say 10 millivolt. Okay, but even if you go around 10 millivolt, you are approaching towards, you know, violating the condition. But here 40 millivolt is fine, absolutely fine. 30 millivolt is absolutely fine. So at least you can use 10 times more voltage over here. This is one advantage. Okay. This is one advantage. So you can use more VGS. However, GM value in MOSFET is less than BJT. So ultimately you are not gaining anything. GM by VGS is always will be less than BJT. Okay. Your IDS value will be always less than the current in BJT. But in this case, at least VGS value you can use at least 10 times higher. However, GM VGS will be, you know, take care of everything. So ultimately you are not gaining, but just to make a point here, a higher VGS can be incorporated. Okay, so this is your equivalent circuit, and this is the circuit where I have put the output resistance, and this is your input voltage. So your output voltage will be somewhere here, V0. Okay.